Hello, welcome to the show. My name is Robbie McKenzie.
And I'm Gina Sears.
And today we would like to talk to you about gifted and talented students.
This is found in chapter 16 of your textbook, so come join us as we explore gifted and talented students in the classroom. According to Ranzulli, some definitions of gifted and talented students is anyone who is above average, has a strong task commitment, and anyone who has a high creativity.
Now we would like to talk to you about a few indicators of gifted and talented students. Some of these indicators are that they have highly unusual abilities.
Many of these signs are recognized early in life, either by parents or by teachers.
And when they are recognized, we usually see this happen at the elementary level.
Now we'd like to talk to you about some indicators of special students that someone can look for. Indicators on page 361 of your textbook regarding gifted and talented students.
These are different signs that you look for to indicate who is gifted and talented.
For example, many can concentrate a lot more than other students.
Also, they learn basic skills better and more quickly than other students. Also like to ask how and why.
And they're very, very inquisitive.
They would rather do things themselves than have help from a teacher or other classmates.
And they're also very fluent and flexible thinkers. I guess that's why it means so much. Also, all children can be potential candidates for gifted or talented students.
Even the ones who may be hyperactive or disruptive in the classroom, we need to remember that we cannot rule them out because they still can fit in the category of gifted and talented students.
It's true. It's important to not neglect those students because they can also fit in the category like Robbie just said.
Yeah, I just said that. Now we would like to look at assessment procedures. The first one is called WISC 4. This stands for Wechsler Intelligence Scale for Children, 4th edition. Another one is the Stanford-Binet Intelligence Scale, 5th edition. And the last one is the Discover System. These all show which students are academically talented.
While these tests can be very helpful in assessing gifted and talented students, they often fail to assess important things such as creativity, leadership qualities, and specific talents that the students may have. That's why they came up with a Torrance test of creative thinking to measure one's creativity.
Now we would like to talk to you about classroom adaptations.
Gifted and talented students require different services than regular programs offer.
Differentiation of the curriculum is needed at times.
Sometimes a program can use acceleration, which is changing the pace of instruction by moving things along faster so children can learn quicker.
An example of this would be children that skip a grade because their intelligence level is higher than the others in their classroom.
Another example would be by placing a student in a class that offers like college level work, so that way they don't become bored with the work that everyone else is doing, and so they're given more of a challenge.
Good job.
Another model would be enrichment. This is providing richer and more varied educational experiences.
Wow, look at that.
This increases critical thinking and encourages someone to pursue their own interests.
The next one is called grouping. This is bringing gifted students in for part or all of the day.
An example of this would be, like in a math class, the students would be grouped according to their abilities, so the teacher could go through things faster.
At a more rapid pace.
Yeah.
That's okay, this is cute. Just add them up then.
It is a teacher's responsibility to make program adaptations that allow for maximum growth and development for all of the gifted and talented students in the classroom.
Two important areas where these students may require special attention would be creativity and problem solving. Well, I hope you've enjoyed listening to us today talk about gifted and talented students.
It sure has been a pleasure talking about a very important aspect in your classroom. Please join us again tomorrow as we'll talk about... I don't know. We'll see tomorrow what we'll talk about.
You'll find out. Just tune in.
We're going to be spontaneous. Cheers.